Do you remember hearing something about blood clots during the height of the COVID-19 pandemic? Today, we are going to be addressing this unusual and rare phenomenon to help you gain a deeper understanding of what this condition actually is. This video is provided for general educational purposes only. Please contact your healthcare provider for more information regarding COVID-19 vaccines. Before we take a look at this condition, let's begin by learning a few key terms that will help further enhance our understanding. Thrombus refers to a blood clot, while thrombosis refers to the formation of a blood clot. Thrombocytopenia is when your platelet count is low. Platelets are a type of cell found within your bloodstream that makes blood clots. Antibodies are proteins that bind to a specific unwanted substance that can help your body carry out an immune response. Prothrombotic refers to a condition that promotes clotting.
With this knowledge, let's take a look at the condition called vaccine-induced immune thrombotic thrombocytopenia, or VITT for short. VITT is an ultra-rare immune reaction that occurs 5 to 30 days post-adenoviral vector vaccination. This is a special type of vaccination that uses a vector virus to help your body prepare an immune response to fight a specific disease. In this case, that would be COVID-19. In VITT, your body mounts an immune response that produces prothrombotic conditions, low platelets, and thrombosis. This is a unique condition where your platelets are consumed, meaning your platelets are low because they are being used to make blood clots. The thrombosis seen in VITT tends to be in unusual locations like in the brain, referred to as a cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, or CVST. Without proper treatment, this can be life-threatening. Now let's look at what occurs on a molecular level. This diagram shows a simplified version of what happens, and we're going to help break it down. In this pathway, the vaccine components bind to a protein released by a granule within your platelets called PF4. The PF4 vaccine complex is then recognized by your immune system, and your body makes an antibody against it. These antibodies then go on to activate and promote the clearance of platelets, as well as a few other mechanisms. Ultimately, this creates conditions where your platelets are being used in the formation of unwanted clots. This clinically manifests as thrombosis and thrombocytopenia. It's important to recognize that the vaccine itself isn't producing any blood clots. Instead, it's a cascade of rare events that ultimately lead to clotting. Now that we understand the pathophysiology of VITT, let's take a look at what happens clinically. Starting with the American Society of Hematology's VITT diagnostic criteria. On the screen is the diagnostic criteria, but let's translate this into simpler terms. The diagnostic criteria includes a recent COVID-19 vaccine, any blood clot, a low platelet count, a positive test confirming the presence of anti-PF4 antibodies, and high levels of a protein fragment made when a blood clot dissolves in your body.
Now that we know what the diagnostic criteria are, let's take a look at some of the symptoms patients may experience. The symptoms for VITT vary based on where the blood clot is located. We have listed a few locations where blood clots have been seen in VITT. For example, if you have a clot in your brain, you can experience visual impairments, versus if you have a clot in your abdomen, you can have severe abdominal pain. This list is by no means exhaustive. If you have more questions, please contact your healthcare provider.
Treating VITT can be broken down into a few simple steps. The first step is an anticoagulant, also known as a blood thinner. Anticoagulants help thin your blood, making it less likely to clot. The second step is an intravenous immunoglobulin, also called IVIG. Immunoglobulin is also referred to as antibodies. By giving your body IVIG, unwanted immune responses that cause clotting are limited. Other treatment options can occur, but that varies depending on your clot location and other health conditions that may be present in the patient.
Now that we know what VITT is, let's dive into who is affected. The European Medicines Agency estimates the incidence of VITT to be between 1 in 125,000 and 1 in 1 million vaccinations. This is specific to certain vaccines for COVID-19 and does not apply to mRNA-based vaccines. Also, in Ontario, out of around 35 million immunizations, 21,843 adverse events were reported, and among these, only 16 reports were VITT-related. Furthermore, as of October 24th, 2022, 29 deaths were reported following immunization, only one of which was VITT-related. We have addressed some common misconceptions about VITT through this video, but we wanted to highlight some specific myths that have also been circulating. One, there is a causal definite relationship between VITT and the adenoviral vector vaccines used to treat COVID-19. This is not true. A causal relationship is plausible, but it has not yet been proven. Two, VITT is common. This is not true. Based on testing limitations early on in the COVID-19 pandemic, VITT was overdiagnosed. However, VITT is an ultra-rare complication. Three, VITT is more likely in people who have had previous blood clots. This is not true. There is no data to suggest that previous blood clots predispose a person to VITT. And four, VITT isn't treatable. This is not true. VITT has many treatment options with the mainstays of treatment including anticoagulant therapy and IVIG.
Thanks for watching, and we hope you were able to learn about VITT. Please subscribe to the Demystifying Medicine YouTube channel to learn more.